Okay, we'll continue in the third part of the Zoom platform. Further process, what we have to do for conducting the online lecture via Zoom platform. In this part, we will learn more about it. Let us move towards the remaining parts of the Zoom. Okay, in this way, in the previous video, I think that we have conducted that meeting, and this meeting has been generated here. Okay, we have created the meeting link. Okay, and here show when we open to the Zoom app, this window will be open. Okay, and after that, just click here. Okay, start. It means that your meeting will be start. You can look at here 16:31. Okay, time is 16:30. 1 minute is over, and on 28 June we have created the Zoom meeting. Okay, and this is the ID and password. By using this ID and password, students or learner or participant can join to your meeting. Okay, then I will start this meeting. Okay, after starting, what will be happen? Look at here. Okay, this is going on connecting. Okay, internet and bandwidth is very important in this regard. If you have got the good bandwidth, then very nice, both side, student side and teacher sides, communication will be proper, no issue will be raised regarding the listening or anything. Okay, it is connecting to that meeting. It is going on process. I think that my said net is okay, but it is not good or better bandwidth, and hence it will take some time. Okay, we will wait here for a while, and after that the meeting will be possible. Okay, just a minute. Okay, I will it is taking a lot time. Only the problem is of the internet connectivity. Okay, otherwise there is no issue. In the next video, we will learn about it.